New tonight, a history lesson from a man who lived through some of the world's darkest days. Sam Freed says there is a million to one chance that he is still alive. As a teenager, he became an orphan, like so many did, in German concentration camps. Well, tonight, Freed shares a message with KATV News Watch 7's Adrian Witset. Don't forget.
World War II Germany. A teenager named Sam Freed, taken from his Czechoslovakian home.
They put us on a train. On a boxcar trains, loaded us. Standing room only. And we didn't have the slightest idea where we were going. No idea.
But as the train rolled into this station in Poland to an orchestra in celebration, Freed knew.
Finally, we realized where we were. We were in Auschwitz. At Birkenau, which is a sub-camp. Birkenau is the one where they did the mass killing.
And in that moment, another realization.
The first 24 hours, I realized I was 15 years old. I became an orphan because I was told that my parents and my family were up in the smoke because they went through selection. Those that looked fit, they selected them on side. Those that didn't look fit, women, children, mothers with children, they all went to the gas chamber.
That selection process highlights deadly medicine creating the master race, an exhibit at the Strategic Air and Space Museum on loan from the National Holocaust Museum. The pictures and video lining these walls tell a tragic story of inhumane cruelty.
Never in my life did I realize that humanity is capable of murdering its own soul.
As you exit the Deadly Medicine exhibit, you realize you've just walked through a piece of history. A piece of history Freed says we're either destined or doomed to repeat.
We are doing it for your grandchildren's sake, for the next generation's sake, because unless you learn from the past, you're bound to repeat it again.
That's why Sam and his wife Frances created the Heartland Holocaust Education Fund, giving money to local colleges and universities.
We did everything together from the start, and I knew the Holocaust was something that people have to know about. I wasn't in the Holocaust, but I am Jewish. And I knew everybody had to know about this.
Freed says he doesn't live in the past. The past lives in him. And he's sharing his story to make sure you hear it.
I want you to understand, and look, you're about the last generation who can get an eyewitness account from anybody. This is it. There is not going to be a veteran. There is not going to be a survivor pretty quick. So it's up to you now to pass it on.
That was Adrian Witset reporting. Freed says he hopes to look down 100 years from now on a world with no racism, knowing enough people passed along the knowledge of the past so nobody ever forgets.